This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to add text to your photos to create stunning photo text posters. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one and the other from Shutterstock. First, we'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, and if we want to, replace it with a different photo without having to do most of the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. We'll isolate our main subject from its background by making a selection around the subject. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, let's use the Object Selection tool. When we hover the tool over the subject, it'll turn pink. When we move the tool, the pink shape will change into a selection. We can check the selection by pressing Q on our keyboard to see it as a quick mask. Press Q again to revert it back into a selection. If you want to add areas to the selection, open your Quick Selection tool and drag over those areas. To remove areas of the selection we don't want, press and hold Alt or Option as we drag over those areas. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll place our text. Open your Horizontal Type tool. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard. We want our text to be white, so we'll need to make our foreground color white. Press X to reverse the colors. Pick a thick, heavy font, since these will give us the best results. I'll pick Alfarn Regular, which I downloaded from the Adobe Font Library. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make its size 210 points, but feel free to make it any size you like based on the font you choose and the number of characters in your text. The aliasing is smooth, and I'll pick Left Alignment. You can align it any way you like. Click on your document and type out the text. To adjust the spacing between the lines of text, known as leading, double-click the large T of your text layer to highlight all your text, and go to Window and Character. Hover your cursor over the leading icon, and when it changes into a scrubby slider, click and drag it to the left or right. Open your Move tool and drag your text. Then close the character panel. Convert the text layer into a smart object as well. Press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of it and drag the original text layer down between the two photo layers. Make the top layer active and reduce the fill's opacity to 0%. This makes the text in this layer invisible, but it'll retain the full visibility of the layer style effects that we'll be adding to it next. Double-click an empty area of this layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. Click the color box to open the color picker. Hover your cursor over a color you'd like your stroke to be and click it. Then click OK on the color picker. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply, the color is Black, and the opacity is 30%. I'll make the angle 135 degrees to replicate the approximate angle of the light in the photo. Feel free to adjust your angle according to the light on your photo. I'll make the distance 15 pixels, the spread 0, and the size 10 pixels, but again, you can adjust these as well. Next, we'll hide the stroke and the drop shadow of the text that are outside our subject. To do this, we'll make the top text layer into a clipping mask, which clips or restricts it to affect just the inside of our subject's layer mask. Press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows, or Command-Option-G on a Mac, or you can go to Layer and create clipping mask. We can reposition our text by Control or Command clicking an empty layer of the other text layer to make it active as well, and clicking the chain link icon to link them together. Now, when we drag either of the text layers, they'll move together as it continues to show our subject through them. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.